that end.
Right now, let's look at these three problems on the sheet, make sure we can do these. This actually was a bonus on the quiz, right? I mean, this kind of thing. How do we write the volume equation for the volume of this? Well, it's going to be length times width times height, yep. And if the original paper was 12, but we chopped an X off on each end, then what's its new length?
12
minus 2x. And what's its new width?
Minus 2x.
And its height, because you folded up the sides, would be
x.
Right? Now, before we go to our calculators, which we're going to have to do, let's talk about domain. Think about this piece of paper. Dan?
It's x is greater than 0 and then less than 4.5.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Now, does anybody want to ask Dan why those two numbers? Does everybody get where those two numbers came from? Emma, Dan, tell her. She didn't know.
It's always going to be half of the length, but yeah, half of the width of the paper.
If you only have 9 inches, Emma, and you're going to cut something off both sides, the most you could cut off would be
4.5.
Yep.
Okay, thank you.
So now I'm ready to go to my calculator, and that's X min and max. What's Y min?
Zero.
Zero, absolutely. It's volume. Kids, you can't be negative. Y max, I have no idea. My calculator is set on 200 right now, so I'm just going to leave that and see what happens. Oh, that worked out nicely. Everybody see in the top of the hill? That's what you gotta see because we're looking to maximize, right? Robert?
When I graphed it, it was like when I had a really big window, it went like, it went back up.
It's a cubic equation. So it's gonna have that cubic shape.
Okay.
But I am only interested in this part of it because the rest of it is not important to me.
All
right. Doesn't, can't exist in the context of the problem. Okay, so now I wanna find the maximum. So we remember how to do that, right? Yes, Mrs. Ford, we remember. My point, and remember the maximum is always going to be a point. I got about 1.7 and 81.87. What do you think? Does that look right to you?
Yep.
Now, what was the question? I want to make sure I answered the question.
Maximum
the question was, find the maximum volume. So what would the answer be? 81.87 cubic inches is the maximum volume of the box. What is the 1.7?
X per square.
That's your X value. That's how big the squares are that you get out of the corners. Okay, the next problem I have all set up. Remember the other day we talked about this and I said let's use a format, amount times percent plus amount times percent equals amount times percent. And I've even gone in and filled in all the percentages. Those are all given to me. Now at least one other number has to be given to me. So what did they tell me?
10 liters.
10 liters. And the 10 goes with the 16, right? Now something's got to be X. And it says how much, 28%. So does it make sense to call that X? So think of your bucket. You're dumping in X, and you're dumping in 10. How much are you going to have in the end?
10 plus X.
10 plus X. X plus 10, 10 plus X. Yep, that's exactly right. Jamie?
Could you make, on the right side, could that be X, and then on the left be X minus 10?
Yep. Sure could be. you just want to make sure your X is not going to be the answer to the question, because this is the answer to the question, so you're going to have to subtract 10 from your X to get it, but yeah, that'll be fine. So we're going to have 0.28X plus 1.6 equals 0.21X plus 2.1. So 0.07X equals 0.5, and I got about 7.14 gallons, liters. You may match that. Good. You may have an issue with that. Okay, number three, another first-year algebra problem. We want to find the percentage decrease. The percentage decrease, or increase, either way. Anybody remember how that's always found? Caleb? Actually, it's the other way around. And it won't really matter, Haley, as long as you understand if it's increasing, you got a positive answer. If it's decreased, you're going to have a negative. So the order of subtraction isn't critical. But technically, it is new minus old over old, or new minus original over original. So that's why I have this set up this way. Notice I'm going to get a negative answer, and that's okay because it's a decrease, right? Make sure when you type this in your calculator, you hit equals before you hit divided by. And I came up with about an 11.8% decrease. The change is negative 11.8%, so that's an 11.8% decrease. Everybody good there? Got that? Yeah, you don't want both. So you either put negative or you put decrease. Okay? All right, let's find in your package. You have something called extra practice 1.7. It's handwritten. Let's go through and get these set up. I think once they're set up, you know what to do, you know how to solve, but let's get them all set up. So look at number one. Oh my gosh, here we go, another piece of paper, another box. This time the paper is 12 by 15. So what will be our equation if we have a 12 by 15 piece of paper? Someone talking. I can't hear it though.
15 minus 2x equals 12 minus 2x times x.
Perfect. This time when you solve it, and we're not going to take time to do it because we got homework questions to go over, but this time when you solve it, read the question again. What am I looking for this time?
The dimensions.
The dimensions. So when I get my picture and I get my point, this is the one I'm going to use, right? So let's say, I have no idea, I'm making this up totally, but let's say that turns out to be 2. Then the answer to the question would be 11 by 8 by 2. It says, what are the dimensions of the box? So if you put 2 in, that would be 11 by 8 by 2. That would be the answer, if x came out to be 2. Okay. Your take-home pay is this. Your monthly car payment is this. What percentage of your monthly pay is your car payment? Be careful on this one. What do you have to be careful of? Yeah, you got weeks and months going on. So what percentage of your monthly pay? So what would be your monthly pay?
About
1920.
And your car payment?
Yeah, the car payment.
Is $230? So wouldn't that determine your percentage, that division problem? So that'd be about 12%? If I typed it in right. All right, here's another mixture problem. So we're gonna do amount times percent. Amount times percent and amount times percent. All right, here we go. What are our percentages this time? 22, 18, and 21. And what amount do we know?
12 ounces.
We know the 18 gets 12. So what are we gonna put here and here? X plus 12. And then you're going to solve it. Tyler bought a new sweatshirt. The original price was $36. It was on sale for 40% off, and there was a 7% tax. How much did he pay? All right, so here's my $36. That's my starting value. I'm standing there at the shelf, and I pull this off, and I say, oh, there's a sign that says 40% off. And it's $36 on the tag. So the first thing that goes into my mind is, oh, it's 40% off. So what percent am I going to actually pay?
60.
So I'm going to multiply this by 0.6 to tell me how much I'm actually going to pay. Right?
You multiply by 0.4 and then subtract that from 36.
You can. That will work every time in a problem like this. The issue is going to be when we get to geometric sequences, we're going to have a problem with that because we're not going to be able to do our problems in two steps. They're going to have to be done in one. So multiplying by 0.6 takes care of the multiplying by 0.4 and subtracting.
Okay, so if you multiply by 0.6, it eliminates the fact that
you subtract. Yep, exactly. It's one operation instead of two.
Okay.
Because think of it this way, Emma. If I'm going to take away 40%, then I'm going to pay 60%. So this will tell me what I'm going to pay. So I'm thinking in my mind, or if you're like me, you have your handy calculator with you, you just pull it out to see. And then I go up to pay at the cash register, and they're going to take whatever this number is, and what are they going to do to it? They're going to add another 7% on. Okay, we're not taking off, we're adding on. So we're going to multiply this by 1.07. This was 1 minus 0.4. This is 1 plus 0.07. If it's a decrease, we subtract it from 1. If it's an increase, we add it to 1. So multiplying all those together will tell me how much I pay for the sweater. But something in the back of my mind is telling me something's wrong with problem 5. So I'm not going to do that right now. I'm going to do number 6. I can't remember. I think there's something wrong with number 5. Let me think about it. Let's look at number 6, though. We have a cylindrical tank filled to a depth of 100 inches. The diameter of the tank is 20, which means the radius is 10. I like to work in terms of radius. the fluid is drained at 12 cubic inches per minute, what will be the volume in the tank after 2 minutes? What is the original volume of water in the tank? Remember, it's filled to a depth of 100 inches and the radius is 10. So what is the original volume of water? Before we turn on the spigot and let it start running out, how much water is in there? How do we find the volume of a cylinder? Pi r squared h. So the volume of water in the cylinder is pi times 100 times 100. Oh, I didn't check. Do all my units match? Was everything inches? Yeah. So the volume of water in the tank is 10,000 pi cubic inches. Does that make sense to you? Now, so here it is now. There's a little drainer thing here. I open that up and water starts coming out. How fast is it coming out?
12.
At 12 cubic inches a minute. So every minute I am losing 12 cubic inches from this tank, right? So after 1 minute it would be minus 12, and after 2 minutes it would be minus 24, and so on. Well, what am I interested in knowing? After T minutes. Well, how much is going to come out in T minutes?
12T.
There you go. There's the answer to the question. That's all there is to it. Nothing fancy or hard about that. Right? I'm going to take a look at number 5. I should have done that before to make sure it's okay before we take a class time doing it. Let's look at our homework. What questions did you have there? By the way, I want to make sure we're clear on what tonight's assignment is. It's important that we do the right assignment. In your packet, tonight we are doing review sheet 1, which is the one labeled review 1.5 to 1.7.
When's this done?
Tuesday. Okay, so make sure you're doing the right one. It's one labeled Pre-Cal A review 1.5 to 1.7. That is tonight's homework. In your packet, you also have another review sheet and a practice test. So we have plenty of practice material. Okay, Hannah, 35. In example 3, suppose the parabolic dish has a 32-inch diameter and it's 8 inches deep, and the radius of the parabolic cylinder is 8 inches. How tall must the cylinder be to fit in the middle of the dish and the top of the dish? All right, I need to look at example 3 to see what is going on there. Okay, so here's my scenario. I have this parabolic thing, and inside it, I'm going to put a cube. So what are the dimensions? That just gives me a picture from example 3. So what are the dimensions? 32-inch diameter, which means, okay, if I set it on the coordinate axis system, this length right here is going to be 32, right? Which means this x-coordinate would be 16, and this x-coordinate would be negative 16. Um,
it's 8 inches deep. The dish is 8 inches deep. So what's the y coordinate here? And the radius of the cardboard cylinder is 8. The radius of the cardboard cylinder is 8. So this is 8 comma something, and this is negative 8 comma something. How tall must the cylinder be if I can figure out what that is, Hannah, if I can find that point, then this will be the height of the cylinder right here. This will be the height of the cylinder, and I can just subtract 8 from that. So if this turns out to be, 7.2, then it would be 0.8. Okay? So, all right, let's see. Well, this is a parabola, vertex at the origin. The equation of a parabola, vertex at the origin, well, y equals x squared is my basic one, but I can put a multiplier here that will stretch it or shrink it, right? I know that that parabola has to contain that point, right? So, can I figure out what that stretch or shrink factor is? I'm going to put 16 in for x and 8 in for y. And that stretch or shrink factor is, that should reduce something kind of nice. 8 over 256, 137. So the equation of the parabola is 1/32 x squared. In other words, the parabola is a lot fatter than usual.
And then you plug in the x.
If I put in 8 for x, I get y equal to 2. So the height of the cylinder would be 6. Okay, all right, you may have another one, not too bad. Not too bad on that. You may have a different one. Robert?
34.
Okay, don't be confused by all the detail of the problem. Basically, here's our rectangular house. It's 16 feet longer than it is wide. So if I call this x, what would this be?
X plus 16.
X plus 16. And I know that all the way around is 136. Perimeter is 136. So what does that mean? X plus x plus 16 plus x plus 16 has to be 136. To solve that, it's going to tell you what x is. Then you figure out what this is. And those are the lengths of the sections. They're going to cut one this long, this long, this long, this long to put up around the house. That's just a perimeter problem. There's a lot of extra information. Okay, anybody else? Bailey?
Number 23.
All right, let's think about the sweater problem that we just did. If X is my original salary, what am I going to multiply it by to get my new salary, which I know is 36,432. What am I going to multiply my original salary by? What? Now be careful. This is an increase, right? So we take 100% and add the increase to it. So what would that be? 1.035. You have 100% of your original salary and you're adding on another 3%. It's like when we did the tax, it was 1.07 because it's 100% plus 7 more. So we're going to divide both sides by 1.035 and that will give us our answer. All right, anybody else have a question about 1? Emma.
I have a question about what we just did. I'm still foggy on why you put a 1 in front of this instead of just doing...
Okay. All right, so let's say this is you and your boss says, let's say you have a job.
Yeah.
Okay. So I have no idea what you make. Let's say you make $10 an hour. Okay? And your boss says, I'm going to give you a 3.5% raise. So your new salary will be this. Now, if you just take 10 and multiply it by 0.035, you get 35 cents. Now, is that what you want your new salary to be? Or your new hourly wage to be?
No, but wouldn't you add that on?
Okay. Yes, you absolutely can do that, but then it becomes a two-step problem, and we're doing it in one. So what you want to do is you want to take X times 1.035 and add it to the original salary, right? That's kind of what you're thinking. That's great. What's 1X plus 0.035X? What do you get when you add those two together? A whole X and 0.035. Don't you get 1.035x? So we're just doing it in one step.
Okay, so by adding the 1, you eliminate the need to add.
Exactly. Exactly.
Why is it 0.035?
What?
Why is it 1.035?
3.5%.
What was the percentage increase?
3.5. Oh, okay.
Yeah, 35%, that would be an awesome raise.
Yeah.
Okay, so again, with percentage, if you're adding on or subtracting, start with 1 and either add the percentage or subtract the percentage and use that number.
So if you're subtracting percent, if your percent decrease, would it be -3.5 or -1?
It'd be 1 minus 0.035, so you would multiply by 0.965. So if you had a 10% decrease, you'd multiply by 0.9. Because if you're... Emma, if you're losing 10%, how much are you keeping? 90. So if I say to you, I'm going to pay you 90% of what I used to pay you, why would I mess around with 10%? I don't care about how much I'm losing. I want to know how much I am keeping. So if I'm going to take away 10%, I'm going to keep 90%.
Okay.
Right? Mm-hmm. Just like the sweater problem. If we take off 40%, I don't care what that amount is. I want to know, what am I going to pay?
Okay.
I'm going to pay 60%.
You should do 28.
28. Did we do this yesterday?
We did 38.
We did 38? Okay. All right, so 28. Okay. So we're going to look at these two jobs. All right, so how do I get paid at the first job? I get $25,000 plus what?
5%
So 5% of whatever I sell. So 5% of whatever I sell, that's my first job. Now the second job is $20,000 and 7% of whatever I sell. And I want the second job to
to be bigger than the first job, so I'm just going to solve that little inequality.
Okay.
And that's going to tell me how much stuff I have to sell to
okay.
make that happen. Some of you might be faced with a situation like that. Some of you might end up selling things on commission. Anybody else have a question? All right, you know what your practice is tomorrow then.